prepare for another flu season. In addition to having a strong immune system, our next guest says tackling influenza room by room in your home can keep those unwanted house guests, also known as germs, from invading your space and really lower your chances of getting sick this season. We have Dr. Ken Redcross. He's the author of the book Bond, The Four Cornerstones of a Lasting and Caring Relationship with your doctor. It's so good to see you back here on Colorado's Best. We love talking to you.
Hello, everybody.
Yeah, so, you know, you really are kind of tackling this room by room. Yeah. I like this concept.
Yeah, because, you know, last year we always think about the workplace and all these places. I'm in New York. We always think when we're out. And I said, you know, why don't we think about what we can do in the home? The flu is back, mm-hmm. as it always is around October.
Come back strong, right?
Come back strong. Now, it's been very interesting this year because you remember last year it was pretty severe. We had, unfortunately, 174 pediatric lives lost.
Oh, my God.
So we wanted to make sure that this year we were really prepared and ready to go.
So we did learn a lot from last year. What are we expecting as far as, you know, it seems like the flu always sort of changes a little bit each year.
It does, and that's part of what the flu does. So knock on wood a little bit right now. Look, things have been a little bit quiet, but remember, last year was the same way until the next probably 4 to 5 weeks. So let's still make sure that we're practicing good techniques and practices.
All right. Before we get to the room-to-room things, I want to ask you, because you are a doctor.
I am.
I have heard about this new, it's like a nasal spray. That really helps if you do catch the flu this year.
All right, so it's a couple of things. So look, there is an intranasal spray that's now been reapproved. It's for those who are 2 years of age and 49. Now, I think what you're talking about is that there's a newer treatment called Zoflenza.
Yeah.
And that's going to be something that's very close to Tamiflu. It really helps with the symptoms. Same thing, though. You want to catch it within the first 2 days.
Okay.
So it's really working well to really decrease those flu symptoms should you get it. But part of the bond I talk about is making sure you can pick up the phone and get to your doctor in time.
Okay. Okay. And it doesn't take the place of getting the flu shot.
Oh, absolutely it does not. Okay. All right. So they're different. It just helps you. If you get the flu, it helps to improve those symptoms a lot quicker than some of the other agents that we had.
Okay. All right. So you say you travel a lot. I know we like, you know, thinking about trying to stay, you know, germ-free on planes and things like that. But staying germ-free in your immediate environment, these look like good tips.
Yeah. Look,
so
these are very important.
Right?
So we're going to start in the kitchen. Yeah. The kitchen's the best place, Paula, because food is medicine. I always love to say that, but I want everyone out there watching to think about it that way. So the first thing you'll see over there is I have cranberries. Cranberries have some good data behind them from a nutrition journal study that shows that they can also help as polyphenols or antioxidants, mm-hmm. and it can boost your immune system. The other thing you'll see over there is that mushroom. Now, mushrooms are fascinating because
that's a big portobello,
right? And so it's interesting because they're antiviral, antifungal, and they're also antibacterial. Now, the thing is that they can be a little bit polarizing for some people to figure out, I'm not a mushroom fan, or how do I get it in? So I mentioned a supplement here called AHCC. The reason why is because there's 30 human clinical trials, that shows its benefit to help boost our immune system.
Really?
And another study that showed that it may potentiate or improve our response to the flu vaccine. Should you consider that?
That's awesome.
The other thing you'll see here, look at all these fish, these cold
water
fish.
Yeah, see the tuna, the salmon.
Exactly. We were talking about omega-3, and you are already on it. So omega-3 is important because it can help boost the white blood cell count, which is important.
Beautiful. All right, let's quickly move to the living room.
All right, so the living room's important because I have that remote control. Everyone watch it. Look at your remote control. Make sure that you're wiping it down. It can be teeming with bacteria. So let's make sure we get that. The next place, the bathroom. Now, we all know that the bathroom is an important place, but mm-hmm. I want you to get rid of that towel and think about hand towels and throw mm-hmm. it in the trash can.
Use them and throw them away.
Exactly. Right? I have the trash can here with the lid because we know that the flu virus can live 15 minutes on tissue. And last but not least, the bedroom. Let's make sure that we're washing our linens at least once or twice a week.
All right. Keeping our environment clean. Thank you so much.
Thank
it's
you.
Always great to have you on.
Thank
Dr.
you for
Ken
having
Redcross.
Me.